I strongly believe that you have to treat the person as a whole and just not the disease. I am Heloisa Soares. I am a GI medical oncologist and neuroendocrine tumor expert. Essentially, I see patients with stomach cancer, pancreatic cancer, colorectal cancer, and neuroendocrine tumors in any places of their body. I wear right now two hats in terms of research. I have clinical research, meaning conducting clinical trials. So if someone comes to the clinic and have a disease that we have a study for it, I will be able to offer to the patient. So that's clinical trials. But the other thing that I'm doing in the lab with Dr. Beswick is developing a neuroendocrine translational program. So using the cell line models and the mice models to develop new strategies for the treatment of neuroendocrine tumors that hopefully, when we're ready, we will be able to translate to the clinic and to be able to offer to patients. So I grew up in Brazil, so I had my school up to high school in Brazil. And I fell in love with biology when I was in mid school, and then later in high school, I fell in love with, you know, the human body. And on the top of that, my dad had a very rare type of cancer, and that led me to be motivated to being to oncology. I also had a lot of family experience with dealing with cancer and seeing what my family members went through. I decided that I want to be the doctor that will be there for my patients from the beginning to the end. That I picked my husband in a Thai restaurant. So he was having lunch by himself, and I saw, why is this good-looking guy having lunch by himself? So I picked up my business card. I was a research assistant at the time in Florida. Wrote down, if you ever need company for lunch, just give me a call. Dropping his table, didn't talk to him, just dropping his table and left the restaurant with my colleagues from work. And then 2 days later, he called and said, hi, I'm David from the card. And then I was like, oh, you don't think I'm crazy? He's like, no, I don't know yet, are you? And I was like, I hope not. So 10 years later, here we are with two kids. In medicine, I'm certainly passionate about bringing good clinical trials to patients. But I'm passionate about patient advocacy. I think that's super important. I have opportunity to advocate to patients in the Capitol Hill. And that's something that it really brings me joy. I feel like I'm contributing an extra layer to patient care. You know, engaging in patient education, that's really something that I absolutely adore to do. I strongly believe that you have to treat the person as a whole and just not the disease. That the disease is just one aspect. It was fun. It's a very, you know, Brazilians are very close to their family. Typically, everybody lives in the same town, which is a little bit different here. Sometimes families are in many different cities. So it was good. We had family meetings in my grandma's house every Sunday night, and then tons of cousins and aunts, and it's super fun to grow with that sense of family. Social media has been really growing in terms of opportunities for patient education. So I will encourage patients to engage in social media in a nice way, following societies that are good. And then if they want to engage in supportive groups in social media, just to be a little bit more careful in terms of what type of information is shared, and because not every single patient is the same, and a treatment that is right for someone might be not right for someone else. Thank you very much for listening. Muito obrigada por me ouvir. Até breve.